So if you ever wondered how streamers are able to bring in their Discord chat bubble and make it show up on stream so that the viewers can see who's talking and who's in the party, well, in this video, I'm going to show you how to go ahead and get that set up in the easiest way possible. And again, everything I mentioned will be in the description of this video. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to come to streamkit.discord.com/overlay. You're going to want to make sure you have your Discord open and that you're inside of a voice channel that you want to go ahead and connect over to this, okay? This is going to be super important because if you typically use this voice channel when you're streaming, this is the one you're going to want to connect. So we'll leave that there. I'm going to mute myself for a moment. And then you want to make sure you have OBS open. Now, you don't need to use OBS Studio. Any streaming platform that allows browser source, you're going to be able to use this. So Lightstream Studio, Streamlabs, and OBS. But for this example, I'm going to utilize OBS Studio. So once you have these things open, we're going to come to Discord and we're going to hit install for OBS. It's then going to go ahead and give authorization for StreamKit overlay to gain access to your Discord channel. So we'll hit authorize. Once you've done that, we'll come right back to the website. And now you have three options here: status widget, chat widget, and voice widget, right? So we'll go to voice widget because we want the chat bubbles. We'll come to where it says server. Here's where you want to select your server and then the voice channel that you want to be able to utilize. Again, I'm using party chat one because that's the one that I'm inside. And then here you have the option to be able to decide whether you want to show speakers users only. So this is the option where you want to be able to hide whoever's not talking to hide and whoever's talking to be able to show, right? So this is going to be your option here. I typically like to leave it to show at all times, but you can decide on your personal preference. I like to go ahead and select small avatars, keep it a little bit smaller. You can decide whether you want to hide the names and you just want the bubbles and the avatar to be able to utilize, but I like to go ahead and show the names. And then you can select whether you want to show your avatar first, meaning that your avatar and your name is always going to be at the top of the list, and then everybody else in your party is going to be under. Then for the text color, again, you can see the preview here, right? For the text color, you're going to go ahead and leave it at whatever color you want based on what background you're going to be able to utilize. So I like to go ahead and leave it at white. Text size, I leave it at 14. The text outline, I have it at black. And then the text outline, I have it at 0. Shadow color, that's going to be the color behind it. You can go ahead and change that to be white if you wanted to. And then when you do that, you can create a little bit more and it gives a little bit more vibrancy to it. And then the background color, that's if you want the background. Again, depending on what game you're playing, the white may get lost. So for me, I like to put a background color to make sure that it's able to be seen at all times. And then you can have the shadow color as well. And then shadow, you can go ahead and create a little bit of shadow behind it. Again, just to make it pop a little bit more when you're in there. So once you've gone ahead and selected all your customizations, you're going to want to go ahead and copy this URL. And we'll come here into OBS Studio. We'll come to the place where we're going to add this in. We'll hit this plus icon. We'll hit browser. We're going to name this Discord chat bubble. You'll simply select OK. And then we'll go ahead and paste this here. And then for the width, we have to put the width that was given to us here. So you'll see 312 by 600. So that's what we want to put in here. 312 by 600. Press OK. And now you're going to see that our chat bubble is now here. So what I like to do is hold Alt on my keyboard. And then when I do that, it's going to bring it smaller. And then now what I can do is that I can increase the size of this. And now you'll see that I have my chat bubble there. And if I come here to my Discord and I mute myself, now you should be able to, in OBS, also see the green around my name, letting you know that I'm talking. There it is. And then now you can now have all your people that you want to add. And again, I've went ahead and shortened it, but you want to make sure you extend it if you're going to have tons of people inside. And if the names are a little bit longer, give it a little bit more width. But now you have that in place. And next time you go live, your party is going to be shown here. Now, if you want to learn how to add other overlays to your OBS Studio to make your stream look professional, like a starting soon, a countdown timer, or even alerts, go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on doing just that. I'll see you guys in the next video.